Good afternoon. This is Chris Brecher with Brecher Trading. Free weekend video combining charts and sentiment to find tops when to sell. If you like this video, sign up for a 10-day free trial. We now have a private Twitter feed where I post all day trades I'm doing, pre-market news, after-market ideas. It comes with your subscription for now. So getting back to it with the markets, you see from everybody, I mean, you've seen it a million times like this. Barron's this weekend, all the reasons the stock market gains are not to be trusted. You have everybody on Twitter bearish, and they've been bearish for about 400 to 500 SPX points. Do I think the market's overcooked? Yeah, but we've been still buying stocks because we don't have three reasons to think that it's over. So let's just go into in August of 2019 and try to combine three reasons of why that market sold off. The first thing I want you to see in here is this. This is the SPX in 2019. As you see, you had a big old sell-off, August of 2019, big old sell-off. What were the tells that you were going to sell off, or the warning signs? I always start with warning signs, and then I go into actionable ideas. So the first thing was the SPX too far from its 50 simple moving average. That's a long way. 29.20, 30.20. So that's about 6%, approximately. I'm not a mathematician, but let's say 5 to 7% in that zone. That's number one. So it's too far away. That's a big old warning sign, but it was too far away here also. So what is the next sign? The next sign to me, and you're going to see, I'm going to replicate this, is stock twitch sentiment. So I do a stock twitch sentiment table. As you see, then this is July 26, right before the dump. 54% of the SPX. This is stock twitch sentiment. So it's a reverse indicator. If it's too many bulls, that's bearish. 64% SPY, as you see in here. 82% of the Russell. 72% of the QQQ. And what do you notice about the UVXY? Yeah, more bears than bulls. That's usually betting on volatility going up. As you see in here, you go into Apple, 74%. Google, 81%. Facebook, 80%. So now contrast that to now. You see, SPX, SPY, Dow Jones Spiders, Dow Jones ETF. Look at this, all negative. IWM only 54% positive. QQQ only 55% positive. They're betting more bulls and bears on the UVXY. Apple muted. Google muted. Facebook muted. Amazon up in the sky, but you know, everybody loves that with the viruses, but that is a danger sign. As you see, very, very muted in here. So keep in mind that even though now we're too far from the 9 EMA, now the scale of this is all screwed up because of that sell-off. Right now, we're 270 points away from the 50 simple moving average. That's over 10%. That's huge. But you don't have any rollovers yet. So let me show you from August of 2019 what the danger signs and when I started initiating shorts. Because you might be right with the markets now, but you don't know exactly when, and you could get your head handed to you. So let's go back into it. I'm using On Demand on Thinkorswim. That actually goes back to a specific time. This is the SPX. First thing, like I said, too far from the 9 AM, from the 50 simple moving average. That's number one. Number two is the sentiment was very, very bullish. So there's two reasons. Now I'm going to put a 4 hour on the left and I'm going to put a 1 hour on the right. The next thing, and so many people get this wrong, as you're going up and every twerk down, you think that's the end. You can't really connect three lines. So three dots. I want three dots. One, two, three. Look at that. And it went up and never broke. There you go. Five. One, two, three, four, five. Really impressive in there on how that worked. Number two is what happened on the right. This is an hourly chart. And as you see, that worked beautifully too. So the reason in there is you have to draw that horizontal line. I can't stress that enough. Now, I'm not saying that this is going to be the biggest sell-off ever. I'm not saying that at all with the broad markets now. What I'm saying is I want to play the reversion back to the 50 SMA. Remember those reversion trades 2 weeks ago? They worked amazing in the Apples of the world and all that. Here's the daily. Sorry about that. So here's the daily chart. As you see, too far from the 9 EMA, you see that, and that's in August. Number two in here, you connect these lines. You connect those lines. That's what you do in there. And then you see the topping formation. Well, there's a couple of other things. Look when this started going down. It started going down about July 30th, 29th in that zone. So I look a lot of the rails. That's what Jesse Livermore did in the 20s. You look at the rails, that's signs of economic activity. Go and look at NSC, Norfolk Southern, back then. So you just saw, just keep in November 29th in there, and I hope this is working. But basically, NSC topped out on July 17th. So go in here and look. July 12th, July 17th. As you see, it got murdered. So when it got murdered, and that's not with earnings, it just sold off on its own. It got murdered. So what happened? Go and put the SPX in there again. SPX was going to a new high. NSC wasn't even close. That's a big old divergence in there. So not only too far from the 50 simple moving average, you had sentiment getting too positive, and you had the rails already taking a dive. And the last thing, and you could put the ES too, this worked well too. What you got in there is you were able to connect lines. This is the ES. Look at those lines you could connect. That was beautiful. I mean, beautiful. And that kept you out of a lot of trouble on the way down. So keep in mind that you have to wait for those lines. Now let's go to now. So number one, you already saw the sentiment. Number two, the ES is tonight. I mean, on Monday afternoon, it's Memorial Day, is up 36.50. What do you notice on the right? You can't connect any lines. Is it too far from the 50 simple moving average? Absolutely. Do you have three reasons? No. You have nothing in there. Hasn't turned yet. What I mean by turn, you haven't seen a reversal pattern. That hourly is not even under the 9 simple exponential moving average. It's over everything. Down here, you might say, well, it got under that. Yeah, but you never could draw three lines. Did you have a little reversal candles? Yeah, you probably need that, but you want to see it consolidate and then have a big three line. See this little one? Yeah, that was a minor pattern. We actually played that, but it was all of 30 points. You want to look for the big lines. You don't have that yet. So that's what I'm going to be looking at in the market, waiting for that. I'm going to look for either three reasons, including the rails. Go look at NSC. As you see, it's not plummeting. I'm not saying it's going crazy. The transports are still trying to form a bottom. But you don't have that massive divergence where they're going straight down while the S&P is going straight up. It's just consolidating. You just don't know yet. So you don't have the reasons that you had back then. Now, there is one other thing to show you. And that's back here. I'm going to go just to here. And this was the big sell-off a couple of years ago. Right here. As you see, you sold off. See that? You connect three lines again. Yeah, it worked again. Then you went down, and you got too far from the 50 simple on the way down. So you knew to have a snap back. What happened? Indecision, reversal candle. You have none of that yet. The point is, and that's NSC. Now we go into the SPX. Yep, same thing. I just want to show you this, whether it's transports or individual stock. Indecision, followed by a dive. So I'm just telling you, you got the indecision in the individual stocks. You have the indecision in the SPX. You got to find that first. As you see, you just don't have that yet. Now, if I see a big red candle take back half a green, reversal candle. If I see this, then morph into some indecision candle tomorrow, and then you get a follow through to the downside the following day? Absolutely. Those are the kind of things I'm going to be looking for to then do swing shorts in the indexes. Have a great day. Hope you like the video. Take care.